Welcome back to the Blazor Puzzle. It's episode 70. I'm Carl Franklin from AppVNX, and that's my friend Jeff Fritz from Microsoft. Hey, Jeff, what's new?
Let me tell you, New York, New Jersey, New England, New Hampshire, it's all new here. We're having a great time.
Yeah, it's been new for a long, long time, hasn't it? Yeah. So, not really new.
No, it's old New York.
Old New York.
Once New Amsterdam.
Well, would there ever be a new Philadelphia or a new Pennsylvania? I don't know. That's a good question. So, a question for another show.
Let me create that in VR space.
All right. You have a puzzle, so let's jump into it and tell us what you got.
All righty. Here we go. I've got an application that I started off. File new Blazor web app, and I turned on all the security bits, and I also included the counter with the interactive server-side rendering turned on. Okay,
sure.
So this is quite literally as close to base template as you can get. I generated an admin user by default so that I don't have to go and register, right? I just put a little thing in the startup that says if there's no users, create a user and register them.
Sure.
So, right, I mean, I can click through and it does all the things. The weather, I set this so that it would take a really long time to load.
Okay.
Authorization, right, there's forcing us to log in. So I can log in with our fake user here. And it gets me logged in. I'm authenticated. I am admin at localhost, and I can click through and see all the wonderful things here.
Yeah.
And that's great.
That's great.
But when I have a site like this, I want to test this. Like, we know there's great unit test frameworks out there. We've got NUnit and XUnit and even BUnit.
BUnit for test. Blazor components.
Yeah, yeah. Test our Blazor components. But when I want to take that next step and do the integration test of I want to step through and actually click on and do some of the things that users would do.
Yeah, you want your test to act like a user and go through the clicking and the entering and the, yeah, all that.
Right, because we're going to get feedback reports that say, hey, I went and logged in and then I went to change my phone number and this didn't work or something like that.
Yeah.
Right? They're going to clearly give us a set of steps. And I want to replicate that and get that same level of integration testing.
Right.
So I added to this project, and you'll see this in our source code in the GitHub repository. I added, when I go over here to the project, you'll see I added down here test project one.
Okay.
I'm not very good with naming.
So I added test project. Is it a test project, just a regular test project from the Visual Studio template, or is that something
else? It is. Yes, okay. It is a Visual Studio XUnit test.
Okay.
But I added in my packages here, right? So XUnit is in here, XUnit runner Visual Studio, but I also added Microsoft Playwright XUnit, you see down here on the left. This is so cool, so much fun, and so easy to use.
Yeah.
Now, they typically describe you having to set up some sort of a page test class to host all of your Playwright interactions. So I like to subclass that and actually provide an additional abstract class that sets up things like, well, here's how big my browser is. And here's the base URL that I'm going to go and navigate to. And I'm going to put some other connection timeout information in here that I want to be standard across all of my tests.
Interesting. I see what you did there, the default navigation timeout, and you purposely added some time to the timeout in the weather app so it would fail, right?
You'd think. More on that.
Okay.
So and I also set up my username and password for that default user that I mentioned I registered in the Blazor app. And I'll just show you that real quick here for our viewers at home. You can see here in program, after I map my identity endpoints and before I run the application, I just go and grab the user manager and say, if there aren't any users, create one, and here's the default user information and the password to set.
That's really smart. Hey, you know, when you watch the Blazor Puzzle, you learn things about ASP.NET Core as well as Blazor. You do. And, you know, you might even learn a few things about C# too.
Oh, the things we might learn about C#.
We might have to call this the .NET puzzle or something. I don't know.
We could do something.
All right, go ahead.
All right. So I went through, I have my page test, and I did things like build counter tests over here that allows me to go and navigate to the counter page. So just like I would do in any other XUnit test, I start documenting and generating what are my steps I'm going to walk through things. So go to the home page. So go to the root, right? Because I have the base URL set up in my page tests. I can just say go to the root. And then I'm going to go find the counter link. Click that, right? That should take me through to my counter page.
Yeah.
And then go find the status. And we're going to try and make sure that it starts off and saying current count 0. Okay. And if I go back over to my browser, right, that's what I want to make sure we land on this page and we have that default text.
Right. Right.
So I do a couple other tests here. And quite frankly, Carl, I generated most of these tests using GitHub Copilot.
Now, that's interesting because, you know, back when we used to test Windows Forms application, I guess they were even VB6 applications back then, we used to be able to use a tool to record our actions. Like, I want to just go out and use the website and have it record the test and then play it back. Is that something that you can do also?
Yes, there is a PowerShell script that comes with Playwright that you can use to start up an embedded version of Google Chrome, the Chromium browser.
Yeah.
That has a bunch of Playwright extensions built into it so that you can click around and navigate around your website, experiment, tinker with, and it will generate some of these statements that you see here inside of my tests.
But you didn't even have to do that. You just put in the comment, go to the counter page, and GitHub Copilot wrote the code for you.
Exactly. Had That's to tune cool. it just a little bit in one or two places, but it generated these things.
Very cool.
And I test that I can increment the counter and that it now says current count 1 after I click the button. I even wrote a little test here that will go through and get a random number of clicks and click it that many times and make sure that it actually gets to that number, right?
Very cool.
And because I have my project running in debug mode in the background, I can actually use the Visual Studio Test Explorer,
of course,
to go through and run all of those tests right here inside of Visual Studio.
Is it doing it in a headless way or is it actually changing the browser?
This is doing it headlessly, but I've got a bug there. See, I've got a test that failed.
Yeah, one failed.
So let me click into that. It's my can logout button.
Huh?
And it's saying, you saw I reset that timeout. It's saying that my timeout exceeded. It's trying to get the link for the logout button. But when I go over here and when I was logged in.
Right.
I'll log back in again. And I've got a logout button.
Yeah.
What's the deal?
Yeah, what's the deal? That's the puzzle, right?
So here's where we need a little bit of your help, friends. We're writing these Playwright tests. We want to click that logout button, but for some reason, it's failing while trying to get the link for the logout. And it's right there, just like the rest of the links down the side.
Yeah, it's not misspelled. It's not two words.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that's the challenge. So this is where we usually pause and play some music, and then we come back and give the answer. So if you want to try to figure it out yourself, hit the pause button, go take a nap, come back tomorrow, whatever it is, and think about it and see if you were right. And you can check right now. We'll be right back. All right, Jeff. So why is this happening?
So this is something, if you've tinkered with and worked with the navigation links on the side here, you know what's going on here.
Yeah, they're nav links.
They're nav links, but the logout is actually a button because it's a form that it's submitting.
Mm.
So this is kind of a easy situation to go through here. So if I just double click on the can log out, you can see the steps that this test goes through. It goes into login, keys in the email and password that we specified, clicks the login button, but it tries to find the logout link. It's not a logout link on the side like the login. It's actually a button.
Oh, so you would think it's a link because login is a link, but logout is a button. Ah,
yeah. So by just correcting that, we can tell it to rerun those couple tests there, and it's going to come back. There it is, logging in, and it logged out.
How did you know that? Can you go to the nav link and see that it's a button rather than a link?
Oh, sure. So here I am back in Edge, our favorite browser, right? Mm-hmm. I'll bring up the developer tools, and I'll scroll down the side here. Let's click on the selection item, and when I click on it, you see button type submit.
But go back up to some of the other ones, like weather or whatever. Are they all buttons?
Oh, sure. So, right, if we look at right here,
that's a link.
The auth required is a link.
Huh. Now, why does logout have to be a button? Do you know the answer to that?
It's being treated as a button because it's also it's doing the cross-site scripting anti-forgery here. So that it does go back to do the logout process and ensure that you really meant to log out.
Right. So it's really a security feature.
You got it.
Yeah. Wow, Jeff. That's amazing. I don't know if I would have been able to figure that out just by, you know. I guess you could, but you know, it's not at all intuitive.
It's not intuitive because it looks like a link, but I think there's a bigger thing for us to learn here about how we can use Playwright to help test and exercise our applications.
Yeah, absolutely. Great stuff. And where can we learn more about Playwright? Just Google it.
The homepage for Playwright is at playwright.dev. I'm including a link to Playwright in the description of this puzzle. When you go to puzzle 70 in our repository out there on GitHub, check out the tests that we wrote, tinker with them, see if they behave the way that you expect. Carl particularly called out that we set a very long time for the weather to delay loading here to demonstrate a little bit longer load process there. But when we ran our weather tests to check to see, does it contain tomorrow's weather? Does it even get to the weather page? You'll notice over here that it those passed. Weather tests, it ran all of them in less than a second total.
How'd interesting. Yeah, how did it do that?
Take a look, friends. See what you can find on how that works.
Oh, is this a bonus puzzle?
It's a bonus. Take a look into it and see what
bonus
you find.
Bonus puzzle. We'll be right back with the answer to that.
We'll take a look at that one next time.
Oh, next week.
Sure.
All right. We also want to give a shout out to Debbie O'Brien, who's the community advocate for Playwright. Richard Campbell and I have interviewed her a couple of times on .NET Rocks, and that's where I learned about Playwright. Really good stuff. So go check it out. And we'll see you next week.
Take care, friends.
Bye-bye. Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out blazortrain.com and the .NET show.com for more great content.